Hey, and we're live. Welcome along to the live stream. Welcome to my channel, which is always fun to go live on because, well, it's my channel. Anything can happen and it probably will. So thank you very much for joining me. I saw we had a few people in the chat already, which is amazing. For those that don't know me and you've randomly stumbled across this video, I guess it would probably be the recording rather than stumbling on the live. If you're watching the recording, hello recording people. I'm Gavin Hoey. I'm a full-time professional photographer, photographic educator, YouTuber, live streamer. Take your pick. We're going to be doing some fun stuff with, you can't see him, I've got loads of stuff over here, with some stuff for attaching to the camera, but I'm not here on my own, so let me just introduce the other side of the camera. You can see them and you can hear them. I've got Freya on the super switcher and I've got Sam on the comments, next to the heater.
Hey everyone, next to the heater. To be fair, I don't move far away from the heater. Hey everyone, nice of you to join us. They're from everywhere, everywhere.
Everywhere, I mean, everywhere is a big thing.
It is. Shall I shout out a few?
Yes.
Yeah, so we've got Sweden, we've got Texas, oh, Italy, sunny Sheffield. Are you sure? Are you sure it's sunny? Because it's been kind of overcast here. Brazil, we've got Kuwait. We've got somebody joining us for the first time. I think there's a few first-time watchers, so welcome. Also, sounds like a 1980s crime show. I guess that's the music at the beginning. Yes, it's quite funky. Someone said it was Austin Powers.
Austin Powers?
Yes, yeah, that's good. Can't find the comment, but yeah, thanks. Keep the comments rolling, and any questions you have, pop them
in. Well, Freya was in charge of the music, so you can thank Freya for the choice of music. It was awesome. Love it.
We just put on something good to dance in the background.
You were dancing. Yeah, that's it. Definitely. I could see them. They weren't dancing. All right. Okay. So thank you for joining me. If you've got any questions during this live stream, pop them in the chat and I will try and answer as many questions if they're sort of connected to what I'm doing. And what I'm doing today is really all connected to this part of my camera. So this is the hotshoe of the camera. Occasionally known as the hotshoe of the camera. Actually, I can't think of it being called anything else. There are a few things you need to know before I get going with any of this. The hotshoes do vary from camera brand to camera brand. If you've got a Sony camera, that has its own kind of unique shoe, but it will probably work with everything else on here, but Sony has a load of little tiny micro connectors at the end, so I'm always a little cautious with Sony cameras. I've never tried one. I should get one in to try it and see how they actually hold up in the real world. But everybody else is going to have a hot shoe that looks a bit like this. Freya, let's go back to a close-up. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so I don't know if you can see, but there are a whole bunch of little pins. I might actually just zoom this in. Hang on. I've got control of this. We're 2 minutes in, I'm already changing it. Oh, that is maximum zoom. There you go. That's as zoomed in as it gets. All right. Hello. So there are a whole bunch of little pins just there, okay? They differ from camera brand to camera brand. These are the hot shoe, if you like. These are electronic pins. That's the hot bit of this. If you want a cold shoe, then it would be no pins at all. It would be just completely blank. But it has this same kind of design that things will slide in. It's really hard to do back to front looking at a screen. Sam, you have a question. I'm raising my hand.
I'm in school. Evian said, sometimes it's called an accessory shoe.
Hey, Evian, yeah, I guess it could be. And that's actually true because some manufacturers, I remember Canon, maybe it's a Fuji as well, have things like EVFs, electronic viewfinders, which will attach onto this. So these things are pretty versatile. We're not going to cover anything that's unique to a camera brand, but needless to say, if you are into the hot shoe part of things where it uses the electronic contacts, bear in mind that they are individual to individual camera brands. But that's not what we're doing today. Today we are doing more generic things. So although it's designed to have a transmitter or a flash gun attached with multiple pins at the bottom, nothing we're going to use today has pins, so I can pop that out of the way. Let's put it over there where I will forget on it about it, step on it in a minute. So hopefully the things we're going to use aren't going to be expensive either. And they are going to be things that I actually use. It's not a definitive list. I literally just went around the studio grabbing stuff and thinking, oh yeah, I put that on the hot shoe. So we're going to start with one of these. And I think this is probably the oldest thing I actually have. There we go. Let's pop that on the top. So this is a little clip-on spirit level. Whoop, which way do I go? Back to front. Hope you can see there is a little kind of bubble in there. So if you want to get your camera absolutely level, a clip-on spirit level is a great little device. It attaches to the hotshoe or accessory shoe of your camera. It can be removed and rotated, so you can have it in the vertical orientation, like that. Actually, that's the wrong way around. You put it, I don't know, it depends. Actually, no, I'm thinking of you. You can't see it because there's a piece of plastic in the way, but I'm seeing this direction, so I'm seeing it the right way around. I'm also gonna have to put my glasses on. Ah, there we go. Okay, and it's a really useful thing. If you're using a tripod that doesn't have a visible bubble level in it, we use them a lot in the studio here for the live streams to get the cameras nice and level. You can have that. You can mount it the other way, and that will allow you then to do both horizontal and vertical. Obviously, not if the camera's pointing straight up in the air. Okay, but super useful, very, very cheap, very, very useful. When I got my camera, it had a black protective cover over this bit, which was good. It was the very first thing I took off, and I immediately lost it. I've no idea where it is. So if you've lost yours and you want to put a protective cover to protect your pins, I mean, literally, I've never had a problem with it, but if that's something that concerns you, get yourself one of these. Let's pop that on there. And that is the same thing, but it has a little bubble level in it. Let me just hold that up. So now you have a bubble level. So if you're looking straight down, you get a sort of single bubble. It's not as useful, but you can see it's completely or very nearly flush. It's made of rubber, so it's going to protect everything underneath. So if you just want something to protect your hot shoe, and you want also the added bonus of a free level, then get yourself one of those. They come in packs of three because they're super cheap. Very, very useful. Here we go. So those are cheap, useful things for popping on your cold shoe for getting your images nice and level.
That's the one that Biggie Z said, and that's the one I currently have on my camera.
Yeah, it's a great little thing. I've got several.
It slips off very easily. This is why they come in multi-packs, probably. Yeah.
Actually, do you know, this one's really hard. I'm going to, let's go for a close-up. Hang on a minute. Let's see if I can really, really, hey, there it goes. That went quite a distance. That was quite a firm one. I'll have it back. Here we go. Whee! Thank you. That was quite a firm one. Maybe they get looser over time, but it is actually, this one's quite snug. And being rubbery, you can actually put it on a bit of an angle as well, just to really snug that in. Oh, there we go. Oh, I think they come in packs of three because that happens and then you lose them. That's probably it. So yeah, little spirit levels, super useful. All right, okay, we are 10 minutes in. A question, I mean, do you use the hot shoe for anything other than flash? If you do, do you have a thing? What is your thing? What do you have on there? Stick it in the comments, let me know. I'm gonna keep going with what I use it for. Alrighty, next most common use thing. I think if I actually had to pick one thing that goes on top of my hot shoe that isn't flash based, it's gonna be this. It's audio based. So these little guys, little tiny radio microphones, super, super useful. So that attaches to my camera, and then the other end plugs in.
You've got some answers when you're ready.
Okay, hang on, we'll have a little close up of this one. I'll plug this in to the mic in socket, which is of course the other one. There we go, like that, with a little tiny cable. And there it sits on the top. Very, very useful when you're out and about because now it's portable, it's attached, it's not coming off, has a little bit of a spring, so if you knock it, it kind of bounces. These are the Rode Go 2s, but pretty much every version of these, and there are so many of these to choose from nowadays, has this, that the belt clip is also exactly the same size for your hot shoe. Just like that. Okay, go on then, Sam, what do we got?
So we've got Candy said mobile phone adapter for filming while shooting.
Hi, Candy.
Kevin, microphone. Kirsty, I use the hot shoe mainly for my flash. Michael asked a question, actually. If you have no cover and not using a gadget, can the rain affect the camera?
I mean, it might. I mean, it's electronic, so in theory, if it was swamped with water, you could get a short, I guess. I'll be honest, in the real world, I've never had that happen. But I would imagine that's a possibility if you have a really wet cold shoe, hot shoe rather, really wet hot shoe, and then you put something in. I wonder if that would be enough to cause a short across it. I'll guarantee you it's happened to someone somewhere at some time, but I've been lucky. Even though we've been outside shooting in rain and snow and everything, I've never had a short on my hot shoe from that. Back in the old days, back when I was shooting Minolta Dynax cameras, that dates me rather badly, then yeah, I did have a few issues with metal cold shoe bits going on here, but I'll talk about that as we go through. Good question, that. All right, okay, let's pop over there. So yeah, microphones, yes, microphones. So, the camera has built-in microphones. They are okay. Let's just leave it at that. They are okay. The rule with microphones is always the same with me. If you can reach it, it's gonna be okay. If it's anything closer than that, it's gonna be good. So my microphone is here, right here on me. So it's that far away. How far away? It is, it's actually appliers now. This is a rarely thing. It's the same width as your screen. That's how far away it is. And that's actually, for a once, that's true. Now, normally that's a joke, but actually it's about right. So if you get your smartphone, it should be about that distance away from your face. So if you're gonna put a microphone on here, if you're gonna get like a shotgun microphone, then you are likely to be really disappointed with the results. Shotgun microphones will cut out sound from the sides, but they won't actually move the microphone physically closer to the sound source. That's a whole nother video though. So it always makes me smile when I see people with shotgun microphones and they're like 4 meters away. Ah, oh, bless. Anyway, there you go. So yes, audio equipment will sit on the top and I'll talk about how I attach stuff like that in a minute. All right, Candy said something about putting her phone on. So let's jump in there as well. So yeah, phone attachments. I've got a lot of them and could I find them? No. So this is a phone attachment. This is one of the ones. It's not one I would suggest, and I'll explain why in a second. Let's go for a close-up. Let's have a little look. Okay, so there we go. So this has a little kind of foot on it. This foot is made of plastic. I like that. It's not metal. It's not going to damage the hot shoe of my camera. It's not going to cause any short circuits. Plastic is good. It attaches onto the... I think it's absolutely rubbish putting this on, probably why I don't use it. Oh, there we go. Like that. Lovely. Oh, look at the quality of this. This is amazing. I wonder why this was stuck in a cupboard. Yeah. Don't do that. There we go. Something like that. Yeah, this is a terrible one. I remember why I didn't use this one now. But this is a phone adapter, so you could get a phone. You could get a phone and stick your phone in there. Whoop. This one's rubbish.
Shall I get the gaffer tape?
Should we do a giveaway? We should do a giveaway. A come and get it giveaway. this is a terrible... I should have really remembered why I got this out. Anyway, that can go in there. You can put your phone in here. Now, there's lots of reasons you might want to use your phone. Maybe you are live streaming and you want to be able to see the comments. So perhaps you want to just, you know, go in and see the comments. I don't have YouTube on here. Maybe I should. Fire that up, why not? Let's go have a little look. Oh, look, I'm live. Go figure. There we go. All right, so you wanna go watch all the comments come in and monitor it, so you could mount that in there. Have a comment thing going on. I could put it that way, couldn't I? Freya came up with a brilliant, what was your idea, Freya? I've forgotten already.
I've seen people do this on, if they're also doing shorts on social media, they might film their shoot with their phone. So they'll clip it on the top of the camera to
like
film,
that?
Yeah, like what the camera sees, that sort of thing, to edit into a short to put on Instagram, TikTok, something like that.
That's a really good idea. So yeah, you could film it vertically, clamp that in, and then have a vertical version for behind the scenes for your Instagram account. That's actually not a bad idea. So yeah, I mean, the only problem is if you're using any other thing on your hot shoe, you can only use this, but we'll talk about that in a second as well. Yeah, or you can go horizontal. Oh, this is... Anyway, you get the idea. Don't buy this one. Buy something better. But yes, I have a few of them that I've got through the years. And that's kind of good. Righty. Other things I pop on my hotshoe is something like this. Here we go. Let's turn it on. What? Look at the brightness of that. Woohoo! Steady now. Pop that on there. This one attaches properly. There we go. And somewhere on here there is a little adjustment. There we go. Lovely. Tighten that up. And there we are. So a little video light. So if you're filming selfies and you want to be in front of the camera, you probably want to have some sort of light source to light yourself. This sort of thing is very, very useful. You can dim it, you can turn it, you can pop it right there. It's not the prettiest of lights. It is very much directional light from the camera axis. But I got this one because we were doing some night photography, or at least there was a potential for filming well after dark, and I just wanted a little bit of light just so I could actually see A, what I was doing, and B, people at the other end. I wasn't worried about the direction of light. So something like this is super useful, looks really good. Yeah, I bought the cheapest one I could find. And then it was cloudy every night. We never did any night photography at all. But that's life, isn't it? That's how it goes. So yeah, that sits quite happily on my hotshoe, like that. All right. Okay, should we get the big stuff out? Let's open the box. Right, let's have a top view. Look at this, an unboxing video. It's like, so exciting. We should do unboxing videos. They're so good fun. So this is a Portkeys. I wonder if it's in here. It feels really light. It could be an empty box. I'll tell you what, it's really well closed. I knew that. I knew that. There we go.
It's a human-proof box.
So this is something we use on every single video shoot. And it is a 5-inch external monitor. So this is a little Portkeys one. It's relatively cheap, which is why I got it. Let's pop the box out of the way because it's really rattly. It comes with its own hotshoe adapter, which screws on like that. And it has a couple of little extra bits that go into the bottom so it can't rotate around. It's kind of designed actually rather well. So that would then sit on top of my camera, like that, lock it down. It has a little adjustable, I'm gonna move that out of the way because that's really rattly. There we go. It has a little adjustable arm so you can adjust the angle of it. I should probably turn it on so we can actually see it. And it connects HDMI in like this. Into there, like that, okay. Oh, turn the camera on, because that definitely helps. So if you're finding the little screen at the back to be a little bit on the small side, then this gives you a much larger screen. So it doesn't look huge compared to this one on that, but trust me, 5 inches, I'm gonna be careful how I say this. This is bigger than this one, yeah. I was making a massive hole for myself there. But super useful, really, really handy. Hey, look, there I am. Hey. Hello. It's really, really useful. But yeah, so you can see all the camera data there, so I've got it all set up. If you do like macro photography, if you want that real close-up detail, you want to go check your focus, then a big screen like this can be useful for stills photography as well as for video. But for video, it's a really essential bit of kit.
So comment from Stu that says, anyone else notice Gavin is very rough with his gear? Ha ha ha.
Yeah, I'm not gentle with my kit. Yeah, I mean, the real world is the real world. If it survives in here, it'll survive a photo shoot. And that's kind of the thing, isn't it? So. Yeah, I don't break much, but I give everything a good go. So that's kind of useful for video, absolutely essential piece of video kit. Let's get rid of that.
Kevin said, technically these are cold shoe items, not hot shoe items, correct?
Well, Technically, yes, they are all attached to the, they are all culture. That's a good point. The hotshoe, and here is when we get into the nuances of the language of photography. The hotshoe is that bit. Let's go for a close-up again. So if you weren't here at the beginning, there we go. That bit, that is the hotshoe, and it's hot because it has electronic connections. That's the hot bit of things. The cold shoe, this one has no electronics to connect into it. Now, it is metal, and you need to be careful. So if these ever get damaged, if you ever scratch this paint away and you're down to the bare metal, then throw that in the bin, get a new one, because there is a risk of connecting pins together. But yeah, we call these hot shoes cold shoes. I don't have one here. That's not true. I do have a cold shoe. Hang on. Okay, so this is a cold shoe. How am I going to do this? Let's move that out of the way. Yeah, that's it. So this is a cold shoe. It has the same footprint. It takes the same things. It will attach onto there, but there's no electronics. So we call that a cold shoe. But annoyingly, we also call that a cold shoe as well. Yeah, well, you've got to love photography. It's like reflectors. When you start talking about reflectors, they can be big, round, shiny, silver things, or they can be things that go on your flashes. We should all agree a standard, shouldn't we, as photographers? But technically, that's a cold shoe. That's a hot shoe. That's also a cold shoe. Hang on. That's a hot shoe. I know. But hopefully you understand where we're going, Kevin. All right, okay, well, that kind of brings us on to my little box of bits. So let's do me box of bits. Box of bits is useful. I have a box of bits. It is literally a box of random stuff that are in some way connected to the accessory mount or hot shoe of my camera. Okay, so these are things that I will attach. I keep them in a little box, which keeps popping open, and then I end up with them all over the floor or over the drawer. But that's the idea. They're looking quite neat for now. Just for you guys, I put them back in here. All right, what do we got? So I have a whole bunch of things. Most useful by far are these. So these, not that one, it's broken. These are little cold shoe at the bottom. Then they have two, and that's important, two wheels. One of them will lock down. So how are we gonna do this? Can we go for the other camera for a minute? Let's stick one on, let's do it. Hang on, let me just put that at the top. We'll bring this in. I'll move myself out of the way so you can see. So it attaches like that. Come on, camera, focus up. There we go. The lower one, let's do it that way around so you can see. The lower one screws down and tightens onto the hot shoe. So now it's firmly on. Okay, it's not going anywhere. That's really firmly on. The top one you then wind down, and now you've got a 1/4-20 or 6mm thread at the top. Okay, it will eventually focus. Hello, how's that? Is that any better? Does this work if I get it face detect? No. That in focus?
It's in focus on the words.
So of course it is. Why would it be on anything else other than the words? Camera autofocus. Anyway, so that's fine. So that allows you then to connect things to it. So what sort of thing would you want to put on there? Well, I could put my audio on. Yep. Okay, so I could attach my little audio in here. So maybe I'm recording external audio. Maybe I'm using this as a shotgun mic. I might want to attach that on there. That can sit there quite happily.
Looks a bit like a bug from the front, sort of like its eyes, compound eyes.
And, yeah, you should have suggested that to OM System. They could have used that in their marketing.
Michael said a cup holder.
A cup holder, yeah. I mean, everybody needs a cup holder in their life, don't they? So maybe a cup holder would be a good choice, yeah. I mean.
Maybe not that sort.
Did I mention this camera is weather-sealed? Oh, right, there's that. You could, for example, get, where is it? Here we go, let's grab this. This thing. Okay. I could attach this to that. There we go. And actually have one that works. Look, I've fixed it. That attaches to there, so now it's actually, it's on. So I've fixed my mobile phone holder. It's not as bad as I remember now, that's okay. I can add things to it. Oh, did I not bring the...
Candy said, I've been known to put a dog treat on mine to get the dog to look at the camera.
Fantastic. Yeah, I mean, back when we used to do kids' photos, we used to have a little rattly thing. It didn't attach to this, but I'd just hold it above. And I can imagine with dog photography, that would be exactly the same idea. You want them looking at the camera, so you need something. With kids, you couldn't really put food above the camera. It didn't really work so well, but with dogs, yeah, I guess you could. That works. So yeah, normally I have an HDMI recorder, which I didn't bring out because it's still on charge. So I attach an HDMI recorder in there and run the cable into that. Whereas I didn't bring it, I can't show you.
I'll just ask you a question while you're doing that.
Ask away.
So Pavel said, I have bought a cold shoe which is full metal with a gap in the middle without contacts. Can a flash attached to it be damaged, or does the flash not give out any voltage?
Okay, it gives out a heck of a voltage. So potentially, depends on the flash. If you're talking about speed lights, it depends, but you might get quite a voltage across these pins. It depends on the system. They are all different. Back in the old day, if you got an old flash, I can remember when we started doing off-camera flash. So, I mean, old days is probably no more than 10 years ago because the speed of technology has been so fast. But the voltage on some of the old flashes was really big, and it was a real issue. It's probably not on a modern flash so much. But nonetheless, yes, if any of these pins touch metal, bare metal, then potentially you might get an issue, but usually what happened is when you put it on, if it touched anything, it would just fire the flash. You just think, oh, that's random, it's just fired the flash. That's normally a sign that it's gone over some metal. But if it's got a little dip in the middle, then you should be fine. But yeah, do watch out for that. It's unlikely to be a problem, but there's always a risk. All right, there's that. All right, what about this? We can attach this to it, here we go. Still from my collection of random stuff. There we go. So, Frey was talking about attaching your phone. Makes sense, but maybe you want to attach your GoPro. So you'll see a lot of YouTubers, particularly when we're doing our YouTube, giving you the FPV, first person view. So it'll be something like this. So you have a little GoPro angled slightly down because it's a really wide shot. And it will film the front edge of the lens and also what's going on in the scene. And you just mount it using one of those cold shoe pins and then an adapter, of which there are many, many around. Something like that. How's that? That works, doesn't it? Okay, so that we've done many, many times. Super useful way of working. We also do it with video as well. It's a handy thing for video. So with video work, if this was actually set to record video, then I can do like a close-up and a wide view from the same point of view. So you end up with two similar viewpoints, but very different points of view. Very, very useful thing to have. Okay, let's get that off there. Don't use the GoPro so much now, but it has been very useful in the past. Also very good, if you're going to do that, is to get yourself a ball head. So this is literally a ball head. This one is about the only one I can actually tell you a brand. I don't think any of these are branded at all because they're all super cheap. This one is by Small Rig. Yeah, Small Rig do a great range of little accessories. Well worth checking out. I have absolutely no connection with them whatsoever, but Small Rig kit is usually a couple of pounds more expensive, but usually money well spent. All right, so that is a little ball head, so you can attach anything and then obviously have a sort of a ball head kind of device on it. Very useful indeed. Okay, anyone ever done any of this? Anyone actually put things on and gone, yeah, that's an absolutely essential item? I'm not sure what I bought this, and I've never really used the ball head. It's kind of a bit disappointing, but it's useful. I'm sure I'll find a use for it one day. I'll find a use for it. All right. So from my little box of bits, if I just dive in here, I've got a few extra bits and pieces in here. Things that I find useful. So this is a kind of really, where am I going? Really useful tool. So this is a reversing thread. So at the moment, I've got the 6mm thread on there, but I can attach this, and rather than having that, I end up with the exact opposite. So if you need to screw something in, that's how you do it. What would you need to screw in? That's a question. Let's attach that on there nice and firmly. Okay, super, super firm. Okay, what about this? Also from Small Rig, but coincidentally, there we go. So this is a magic arm. So this is a little magic arm. I use them all over the place in the studio. They have little threads at the end, standard size threads, and they lock. So if you get a tighten up in the middle, it locks into shape. Absolutely vital tools here in the studio. They're all hanging out the ceiling in various places. One of the cameras, in fact, this very camera that you're looking at now has one of these on the end of it and is up in the ceiling. But that I can now attach to the end of this. So the way I do this, lock everything straight, lock it straight. Okay, and then you can screw that in nice and easy. Okay, look at that. Well, look, let's go for a wide picture. I mean, this now, finally, this picture makes sense, doesn't it? Whoa. Sorry, I fell off my stool. It's like that exciting. Look at that. Who wouldn't want to do that? I mean, what use could you think of that? What would you do with, now you've got this, that you can kind of angle? Can you think of a useful use for that?
I think you could put a Christmas star on it at Christmas.
You could. That's actually not a bad idea, Sam. Actually, if I take your idea and modify it a little bit.
I think you call it make it your own.
There we go. Whee! Right, so now you don't have to have it sort of on camera. You can have off camera flash. You can put it over to the side. How's that? Okay. So now you can have off camera flash, off camera lighting, off camera LED lighting. So if you're doing close up product work, I can actually light this from the side. Oh, yeah, this mug is amazing.
Biggie said an LED for macro videoing insects.
Yes.
Michael said a back scratcher. I mean, that's a good thing to have, okay? Yeah.
Actually, Michael, that is actually quite nice. Yeah. Yep. So that kind of works. Let's turn that off. So there's that.
Did you add the links to the things?
No.
No.
No. What do you think I am, Adorama? No, I mean, if you want to know what this is a Small Rig, I think it's like an 11-inch magic arm, I think that one is. It's size-wise, hang on a minute, I can tell you how big it is. Okay, size-wise, it's roughly the same as the width of your screen. I'm going to get that on a mug. Okay, that's kind of fun.
So Micah said, I'm still waiting to see if Gavin pulls out a shoe mount umbrella for shooting in the rain. I just learnt they existed the other day.
Whoa, what?
Crazy.
A shoe mounted? I mean, I've got a weather sealed camera, but if I ever ditch this and go for a normal camera that's not IPX rated, that would be a genius, wouldn't it?
And then Michael asked,
hang on a minute.
Oh, a minute.
I'm mulling that over in my head. I was doing a shoot last month in Spain and we were filming in the snow. It was snowing. Everything was trashed. It was really, really bad. I wasn't worried because it's weather sealed, but what I was getting problems with is the front element of the lens constantly getting snow on it. If I had a little umbrella over the top of it that was just like, you know, on an arm that I could just angle out just over the lens. Oh, that's genius. Well, it's got to be slightly bigger than one of those cocktail umbrellas. But not as big as a proper umbrella.
Oh. Anyway, back to the question.
No, I think that's brilliant. I love that.
So Michael's asked, do you ever use cages or eye brackets?
We're going to come on to that in
or
a bit.
Or is it L brackets? Eye brackets or L brackets?
The spoiler answer is no, but keep watching. Okay. You could do that. You could You could get your GoPro and have an alternative angle, so it's not exactly in line with the other camera. So you could have that as a side camera. There's all sorts of things you could do with that. You could put your field monitor on it and have it over to the side. So maybe you don't want it directly in line, so you could put your field monitor kind of sideways on, like that, and I could screw that in there. So I have a field monitor off to the side. These things are so useful, and it works because I've got this little intermediate part that turns the thread from a male to a female. Yeah, I think it's that way around. Very, very cheap. Again, they come in packs of five. Super useful.
So there's a comment here from Gerald who said, you probably want to be careful how much weight you put on the hot shoe.
Ah, Gerald, yes, thank you for reminding me. Okay, so think about this. The hot shoe is designed to take the weight of a speed light. Keep that weight in mind, because if it's any heavier than that, you are potentially putting too much weight onto your flash. Now, you've got to take that even further, because that's weight that's designed to go vertically straight down. And there's a little bit of tolerance, because everybody picks the camera up by the speed light. It's kind of not everybody. A lot of us do. So there is a little bit of tolerance in there. But if you're really putting something heavy and putting it on quite an angle, then there is a risk. And I've come a cropper on that. I was doing macro work for a long time where I had a speed light really craned out on an arm a bit like this, and it dislodged the hot shoe a little bit, so it was a bit wobbly. It didn't stop working, but it became a little bit kind of wobbly. I know it's working because you're actually looking at the camera that happened on right now, and it still works. And it's got something attached to the hot shoe, so it still works okay. But there was a definite play in it after that. So if you are going to put stuff on, yeah, bear in mind there is an upper weight limit. These things were not designed to be abused, but they get abused, so I guess they did put some design work in there. All right, okay. Oh, one last little use. And this is definitely one for anybody who does work to camera, video work to camera. So, if I get that up there, I'm going to attach this to it. This is a little grip. These things are also super useful, but that's another story. Okay. And what I can do with this is, if I'm doing a piece to camera, I'll have notes. I'll have little notes, but I don't want to. I want to try and look at the camera as much as I can. I've got a monitor, you can't see it, but I've got a little confidence monitor just below, so my eye line stays more or less on the same line as the camera angle. And it's the same as if I'm doing notes. If I'm reading something, I don't have an auto cue, but I will have written notes, and I will attach them like that, just out of the camera frame, something like that. Great, so now I've got a little kind of poor man's auto cue. So I just write bullet points, and these are actual bullet points from an urn. They're upside down. Top tip. I wonder if anyone noticed. There you go. Put them the right way up. But that means that you can actually keep your focus on the lens when you're talking, but actually read your notes so you have a guide to what's going on. So sort of a poor man's auto cue is super useful. All right, okay, let's get that off there. We'll take that off. Cool, we've been going 40 minutes. All right, we should probably jump towards the end. Let's see if I can get that off as well. Yeah, and there we go. Okay, what have I got left? I've got one thing left on the desk. So this. There, that. How's that? So this is a handle. It is a little grip. Has it got the brand name? Oh, it's a newer. There we are. That's a known name. A newer video handle. These are super useful. So they attach on there like that. So you can either attach them this way round or that way round. Okay, they go in either way. I prefer that way around, because it just balances everything up a little bit. We can't quite see, I've gone in a bit. Oh, there we are. I've gone in a bit tight. But that just balances a little bit better. Okay, so that feels really good. So if you need to do particularly for video work, anything like that, it's super, super useful. If you do it the other way around, if you have it on the other way, it just means you're constantly tilting it up and it kind of works on the wrist a little bit harder. But if you're not doing video work, then the bit that's actually interesting is around the front. Can we go for a close-up? Ah, there we go. Okay, so if you were here earlier, we were talking about hot shoes. Can you just pan up slightly for me? There we go. Whoa, look at that, fantastic. Okay, we were talking about hot shoes and cold shoes. So this handle has extra cold shoes, and they are cold shoes, there's no electronics in there at all. So if you want to attach something, you can. So for example, if you wanted to attach, let's stick something like that on, there we go. Something like that. Undo it enough, pop it in. Okay, so you wanted to have your B-roll camera, your behind the scenes camera, your POV camera, whatever it is, you could pop that on there like that. Just tighten that up. Lovely, something like that. You'd do a better job than I'm doing, obviously. You could then add in your audio to the side, like that. Okay. So I can add multiple things in together and I can start building this out. So somebody asked earlier about cages. I don't have a cage so much, but I do have various ways to attach multiple things to the camera. So we often run multiple of these little Rode go-tos. If I'm doing a multi-person interview, you can do one person or you can do two people with one receiver. If you're doing more than two, we sometimes do three or four people. I need two receivers, so I can actually attach a couple of receivers. But top tip, if you're going to attach multiple receivers, then this little gap isn't enough. There's not enough room between the two. The two receivers will interfere with each other, limit your range, which can be a right pain. So bear that in mind. You might have to come up with an alternative solution. If you don't want to use a handle, last one I'm going to leave you with is from my box of bits, one of these. Hang on, there it is. One of these. So this is the cold shoe adapter. This is 1 to 3. So you use one hot shoe and you turn it into 3 cold shoes. Usually they come like this. It has a little thread at the bottom and you should be able to buy it as a kit, including the little thread. Let's just grab that. There we go. So that then screws into the base of there. Whee, around it goes. Attach that through there, tighten that in, lock it down so it's nice and firm. So now I have one cold shoe becomes 3. So I can attach that to there. Urgh, nice and tightly, lock everything down. Something like that. There we go. So now you can put multiple things in. It's a much smaller footprint. You can get them flat as well, but I kind of like them like this. And I like it because it has this little hole. So if you need to attach something like this to it, okay, you can then run that cable through there, the other way around. Run that cable through there and into there. So it's just a little bit of cable management. Let's do it so you can see it. That attaches to the mic in. There we go. Lovely. Okay, so it's just a neater way of doing it. You could use transmitters if you need to use multiple transmitters. I don't think that's a thing anymore, but that used to be a thing. There's all sorts of little uses for this, but these things are super, super useful just to have around, I guess. Well, you can't know. Actually, no, you could. Do your camera in vertical as well. Film vertical content with your GoPro. So many usefuls. So kind of useful bits of kit. Not expensive. So those are all the things I attach to my hot shoe of my camera on a fairly regular basis. It's not a complete list, but that should be enough. Hopefully you find that useful. I hope you found that useful. There are absolutely no affiliate links. So if you want to go and get any of this, that's fine. It doesn't make any difference to us at all. If you found it useful, terrific. Have we missed anything? We've got any other questions? Any last comments, Sam?
Stu has asked, when is your next live?
Oh, the next proper live, when it's actually something useful, is, I think, just under five weeks
I think it's the 14th of March, Stu, if you're looking for the Adorama live.
So yeah, back on Adorama TV.
We'll probably do another one on this channel.
We'll probably do a couple of these because, yeah, why not? They're fun. They're kind of useful. If you found them useful, if you found them helpful, if you want us to do more with various bits and pieces,
click the like.
Yeah. Oh yeah, we haven't done any of that, have we? We are rubbish at this.
We are rubbish at this. Yeah. Actually, people are saying that for us. So thank you. Yeah. Molly's put on 158 watching, only 78 likes. Required, people.
I mean,
it's not a requirement, but you know, it would be nice.
I'm stunned there's 150 people watching. Well, thank you.
Well, there's a bit more. There was a bit more than that just now.
There was a bit more.
Yeah, they're all gone now.
Yeah, which is fair enough.
And if there's anything else that people want.
I was going to say that.
Sorry.
Put yourself on camera and say that. There you go.
Is there anything else you want? It feels more like a threat now.
Yeah.
Do let us know. Put it in the comments or say now.
I just realised we're matching. It's like we put a uniform.
I saw someone said that.
Yeah.
Totally by accident.
It is, yeah.
But I'm okay with it. We often end up matching. So if there's anything else you want to know, anything else you think, I would just pop this in, you know, quick question. It doesn't feel like much. It might be much. So it might be something other people are wondering as well. Maybe it's something that we couldn't spend longer talking about. So please let us know.
Yeah. So we think we're going to do another one next Tuesday, but that might be the Tuesday after. It all depends on how busy life gets. But we'll stick a note down, as always, an hour and a half before we actually go live and we go, yeah, let's do it. That's fine. So these are much more casual than the Adorama ones, which are planned quite a long way ahead, which I kind of like. So there you go. Thank you very much to Sam and Freya for doing behind the scenes on this one.
Thanks, appreciate it. Thanks everyone for all your comments and the chit chat and everything. We really do appreciate it and they are fun. Thank you.
Oh, almost made it through without coughing, which is pretty good. Yeah, pretty good. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you found it useful. Thumbs up. Like, subscribe, all of those things, always good. We'll be back in a week or 2 weeks time on this channel and a few more weeks over on Adorama. So I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.